the 20 cells needed to power my heat shield. Now be careful. The shield will only protect your Zoomer till it reaches 500 degrees, so try to keep her cool. Flying over open lava will definitely heat you up fast. Hit 500 degrees and it's over.
Over? Like burning molten metal over?
The fire canyon gets pretty hot, so keep a lookout for jumps to keep you off the hot ground. I've also released several blue cooling balloons you can use to drop the shield's temperature quickly. Oh, and when you get across, don't forget to activate the teleport gate in the Blue Sage's lab. Then we'll be able to teleport over and meet you. Good luck!
Hit those balloons to cool off! There's scout flies out here, too! Ooh, see if we can catch air off those workers!
Thank you. don't think I'll ever get used to that teleporter tingling sensation. Hey! It looks like the Blue Sage threw a party.
Oh my! Rock Village is on fire!
One heck of a party.
No, no! I mean Rock Village is being bombarded with flaming boulders! Oh! And it looks like the Blue Sage is working on a levitation machine to move them. Assuming it's operational, we're gonna need power cells to fuel it. I guess you two are going to have to find some ore.
We'd better take a look at his notes. Jack, go check on the villagers. Then come back and give us an update. And take the furball with you. The situation here stinks worse than a lurker's armpit. Before Blue Sage's disappearance, he journaled significant trouble in all of the surrounding areas. Of particular interest to me is the dark eco-infection of some innocent plants in the Precursor Basin. Kira will teleport your Eggrav Zoomer to the nearest transfer. Ride the Zoomer to a green eco-vent, and then carry the green eco to the corrupted plants. That should heal them. Don't miss a single plant, or the infected ones will slowly reinfect the healthy ones. And Daxter, start cleaning up in here! And don't forget the corners!
Apparently, the precursor structure just off the coast leads to an underwater lost city. The Blue Sage has been trying to figure out how he can bring one of the chambers to the surface, but he was never successful. You should check it out.
Aren't there a lot of lurker sharks in that water?
Why? Are you scared?
Me? Of course not. Just looking out for Jack here. You know what a chicken he can be.
Well, if you swim out over the coral reef, I doubt the lurker sharks will bother you. They don't like shallow water.
Fellows, I've got a research project going, and maybe you could help me out.
Hey, we're the ones on a big quest here. We ask you for help.
Well, perhaps we can help each other. I've been studying the burrowing habits of lightning moles in the Precursor Basin next to our village for years. But now those awful lurkers have scared the moles to the surface. And since they're blind as bats, they can't find their way back underground. If you could herd them back into their burrowing tunnels, you might just save their lives. I've got a power cell that says you can do it.
Yeah, lightning moles. We can. Maybe for two power cells.
Nice try. But I would be willing to part with another power cell if you two find me 90 precursor orbs for my research equipment. Fair enough? Oh, you have the orbs. Here's a power cell we agreed upon. This stone is very old.
Thank you. Yeah. armor. That's one more power cell.
Okay, your moment of gloating is over. Get on with it!